Hello guys, it's the admin of DIB 12340 here, your home channel of bus educational video contents of Singapore. So, this is nothing got to do with the vlogs or any other bus related videos, but however, it does relate to the community of the bus enthusiasts in Singapore and also throughout the entire island wide of Singapore. So, before that, don't mind me being like this because I just feeling more fatigued. As I just got my second dose of my vaccination of COVID, and the side effects is really killing me, so do mind about that. So at on around 1 hour ago, at the time of this video was being filmed, on the 11 June 2021, Friday, just in case not many people would like to see the calendar, at 2:08 PM. Somewhere around there, there's this one user that enters to the Discord server, which the name that you guys by now, I think I should, yes, better. So on around 1 hour ago from the time of this film, at 2:08 PM, there's this one guy that enters our Discord server. And one thing that makes everyone suddenly spamming all around the server is this. Just in case if you want me to read it out, so let me just read it out. So it says, "Stupid fucking Malays do not deserve to live. The admin of TRB 12340 was very good to me previously. He will deny this forever. Stupid motherfucker who will just go ahead and ban me and act like nothing happened." That being said, quite coincidentally, 24 hours ago, from the time of this post, there is this one username called Malay Fuckers who just slide into the Discord server. Because when I was being notified whenever people join the server, this name was bringing me some attention, a lot of attention, and this makes me to immediately ban the person from the group, even though the person just entered the server. But because the name that actually makes it offensive towards everyone inside the server, I have a right to kick anybody out that involves racism, hate, and also discrimination of religion. So at this Discord user, Discord server of TRB 12340, we are very open to everyone who that we, especially me, I am really welcome to let everyone, regardless if our bus enthusiasts is Singapore or outside Singapore, those who are very long in this hobby or those who are new in this hobby, or even the members of the public who wants to know more about the discussion about buses in Singapore, you guys are welcome to join the Discord server. It is 100% kindness all everywhere. In the server, everybody treated like we are in a one big family. At the total of nearly, I don't know, 69, 70 people, it should be more than 70 people inside the server right now. The whole, more than 70 plus of us are a family. Regardless of our skin, our language, our religion, our race, our background. So no matter what, at the end of the day, when we are going to the afterlife, we are still as one human being, no matter how much differences we are, but until at the end of afterlife, we are still the same as a human being. But one thing that I would like to make this issue is that because recently in Singapore, there's a few cases that involves racism between the majority, but this time now, I have to raise up my thoughts and opinions towards everything. I'm not being scared, and I am not afraid to raise my voice to our dear minority friends, and also giving this as a balance of what is happening in Singapore right now, which is involved racism. So there are currently two cases of racism in Singapore. One is the a pair of couple who they are dating, but both couple are not in the same race. Both of them are actually come from a different race, one Indian guy and one Chinese lady. And another one is, there's this one Indian guy who was praying outside the house. I'm just describing, I'm not being racist, I'm just describing. He was praying using the bell outside this bell outside the house. I know it is to like keeping away from the evil spirit coming to the house. Correct me if I'm not. Correct me if I'm wrong, guys. If you guys are Hindus, and if you guys think that I'm wrong for saying that, you can comment the actual reason about it. So I'm just describing it. And then there's this, and then both different separate case. One guy who is formerly unpoly, a lecturer who apparently being racist because apparently, for example, Indian and Chinese cannot date each other, blah blah blah. Then another one is this one lady with the, I don't know what you call it, the gong, like dong dong gong gong or whatever thing, like it's really racist. And I really seen it online, sometimes I seen it in real life, but I'm seeing this throughout my entire 20 years old life, I have seen right in front of my own eyes, even though it's behind the screen online thing, I would say that I am also part of the victim in this racism in Singapore that is currently trend. But I'm not the only one. Those Malay bus enthusiasts in the server were also affected, because when the person says stupid fucking Malays do not deserve to live, when you were mentioned about that inside the server, it means that you are telling everybody, the whole Malay people inside the Discord server, not just you, not just that person, but the entire Malay community of bus enthusiasts inside the Discord server. Oh, let me give you this issue. The admin of TRB 12340 was very good to me previously. He will deny this forever. Okay, let me tell you guys something. Now it's 2021, okay? And mainly, I am not those 15-year-old kid anymore that are being childish to people and all this. I had grown up, I had seen the past, and it's time for me to move on to better things. Yes, I am guilty of what I've done to some people and all this. I mean, in fact, all of us as human beings, we are also being like that last time. And as time goes by, when we are growing up, we are feeling forgiven. We have to forgive amongst each other, and then let's move on with life. But that doesn't mean you want to have some attention by bringing this up to the entire people inside the server and whatsoever. If you, let's say for example, if you have some stir shit with me, you can just DM me or PM me personally, and we can just talk about it. You do not have to spread this thing across the server so that other people want to see for the sake of your attention. But that's not the point for this case. But the point is, bringing up a race inside the Discord server and threatening not just one person, threatening the entire race in the community is already a full stop. It is already a full stop. There's no more waiting. It's time to take some legal action. Hijin, yeah, you guys know Hijin. He WhatsApped me personally and he asked me if I would like to bring this to the police. First of all, I'm very sad to say this. Unless it is a physical thing, the police will take action. But because this is an online matter, back then, if I'm not wrong, back in the past, I think it was like 4 years back, I was facing this racism issue thing. Unfortunately, the police cannot do anything about it. This is the reality. The police cannot do anything about it. Even though if you are being racist online, the best thing that the police will say, just ignore it and block the person. And yeah, and that's the best advisory that they can give us. I cannot blame them because I don't know what's the real procedure behind it, but apparently I also don't have any right for me to blame the officer who telling me that, or any officer that tell me the same reason, we cannot do anything about it when it comes to racism online, all you have to do, but best thing for you to do is to block and all this. To me, okay, fine. I don't blame you as well because that's your job, and I think that's part of the procedure and the law and all this, so I have to give myself some respect for that. But one thing that I do really mind is that because this thing has happened a lot nowadays in Singapore, even though a few years back until now, we as minority have been keeping quiet, and we are keeping quiet because of the law here, which apparently, unfortunately, they don't let us to voice out our rights as a minority to fight for one another. So, but for this, but that's not the issue that I bring up here. The most issue that I actually wanted to bring up is the part when the person says, stupid fucking Malays do not deserve to live. And you bring this racism into a bus enthusiast Discord server. Which at TIB12340, in this Discord server, again, like what I mentioned earlier on, in this server, we would more talk about every day in the bus industry, the community itself, where you guys want to talk about those like future bus planners and all these, some of the bus memorable collection items and all this, and that is related to buses. I'm like, go ahead, I will just keep it as a piece, because that's who we are. We as a bus enthusiasts, we don't focus on one race or another race. We don't focus on skin. We don't focus on our own language or our own religion. But we are mostly focused on what we usually do as our everyday life as a bus enthusiast. So that is the one of the most focused thing, focal thing that we do on the server. Racism is a very strict rule in the server, which me as the admin, I will have to kick every right to kick the person out. Whoever that is against, that really went beyond the rules, will have to ban from the group immediately. So with immediate effect, for those of you guys who is not inside the Discord group and wanted to join my Discord group, Discord server, unfortunately I will make it as a lockdown. Singapore session, lockdown. So for now, I will temporarily not accepting anybody to join inside the Discord server at the moment until my end, this investigation will be complete. This means what kind of investigation? I will have to review up with the rules. I have to make some rules from the existing Discord user inside the server, and also to helping me up to keep a lookout from these people that is trying to break the rules. So, and this will never be the end of racism in Singapore, and I'm sadly to say that although I'm actually Chinese Muslim, to be fair, personally I'm Chinese Muslim, but this also affects me as well when the person say stupid fucking Malays do not deserve to live, because I have a lot of Malay friends as well, and also there's a lot of Malay bus enthusiasts inside the community server, and I am protecting these people from being the victim of a racism. So this being said, that for now I will be temporarily hold for those people who wants to join the server until further notice. This will take at least 3 to 6 months, sadly. Until once everything is safe, then I will open the link again. So thank you guys for your support, and if I have been stirred with anybody around, so I would like to apologize for that, even though it's way back in the past. But if you really want to make a settlement issue between man to man, one to one, you can just DM me personally on Instagram or this or Discord personally. So, and all we have to do is that we just have to keep our bus enthusiast community safe. There is no room for racism, not just in the server but in the bus enthusiast community. So yeah, and that's the end of the statement here. And once again, because I was filming buses for Fun Fact Friday, this was when I look on my phone, see the frequency of service 35, until when I see that there's a lot of people tagging me on server. So when I open up and I see there's a lot of spam. This person did not send one message, but he's like spamming like 18 or 19 messages, and I had to delete it in one time. So this means it, and I would like to apologize for anyone who is affected by the racism of this. This person was with spam inside the server. I would like to apologize on the behalf as the admin of the TRB12340. So until then, let's stop this racism in Singapore, and let's make this community as a peace for one another. So thank you guys, and I'll see you soon.